What's wrong with American men? Nothing. Our doctors are greedy and corrupt.
Hey, has everybody heard the good news? You don't have to cut your son's penis. Boys are born perfect too.
Bro, you probably got dick too.
Your body belongs to you, not your parents. Your penis belongs to you, not your mom. Thank you for keeping an open mind. Boys are born perfect too. Alright, appreciate you, brother. Thanks a lot. Keep an open
males,
mind.
Males, females, and intersex babies deserve equal rights.
Stay curious.
Everyone here was born with foreskin, and you all should have been able to keep all of your body parts.
Be a man's choice, not a parent's choice. It's our university tour. Okay, we were at Oklahoma State yesterday because we run into so many wonderful people like you all who are open-minded. You haven't had babies yet. You haven't had these doctors come at you. Once parents have circumcised a baby, they have like this built-in defense mechanism. Many of them do. They don't want to, oh my God, I did make a terrible mistake.
I was very surprised. I've never thought of even protesting something like this. I mean, we have protesters here for many different things like veganism, stuff like that, quite frequently. I just know that it's more common in America than everywhere else. That's really the only thing I do know, that it's more common here. I know in European countries, they're kind of against it.
I think it's a pretty exciting thing. Like, I think everybody should have the right to their own foreskin. I mean, it's like, why get it cut off at birth if it's something that is traditionally thought to help and pleasure in situations like that, and I think it's just kind of dumb to make that decision for a child and another person.
I think when you see the Tosh episode, it'll give you follow the curve of this paper.
So curving this way, we're coming this way.
I mean, these are all bad things that need to be fixed, so it's honestly a good thing that y'all are out here doing this for everyone.
I agree. I didn't know what to think at first, but now that I'm out here and I've been talking to you guys, I think this is a noble cause, and I'm just glad to be out here supporting you.
And to be honest, I didn't even think it was that big of a problem until I'm seeing all these signs and stuff now. You guys are actually bringing light on this. It's a good thing.
It's actually quite a serious problem.
It is.
Some children lose their whole penis. Some lose their lives.
Wow. See, circumcision is... I don't really know, but I do know it's a bad thing, and I do know that... many people are at fault for it.
And, you know, honestly, I hadn't been thinking about it for very long. I've been circumcised for as long as I can remember. And it's just now that you guys are out here, it's really coming to the front of my mind. So.
Yeah, you really brought this to my eye. I really had no idea this was kind of a problem. But now that I know it is, I'll kind of do some further research and look into it.
And the Tosh.0 show is a good place to begin because he's very, very much against circumcision.
Wow, I know that.
Sir, he came out against circumcision on his show a number of years ago. They contacted us, Bloodstained Men, and flew me to Hollywood to do the interview.
That's awesome.
I tell men, it should have been your choice, it should have been my choice, it should not be a parent's choice, it's not a doctor's choice. They don't do it to babies in the rest of the world's hospitals. The only men in the world who are circumcised are Muslims, Jewish and Americans, and the Muslims and Jewish don't claim it's medicine. Only Americans claim it's medicine to give it some kind of veneer of respectability. But essentially, it's like a tribal mark on our bodies. It's unfair to us. It's unfair to our sons, to our grandsons. We are serious about ending this ASAP because babies are suffering.
When we're talking about what we call the relativist fallacy, which is when we think about cultural relativism and the importance of seeing all cultural practices as valid, that's an awesome thing to do, but we also have to take into account when human rights are being violated. So we call that term the relativist fallacy, to help students think about how sometimes we need to think critically, not only about our own practices, but practices in other countries and other cultures. Yes. So that's the context in which we talk about it.
How do the students react to this subject, being that this is commonly practiced in the United States?
They are oftentimes very surprised. Yeah, very surprised.
And how thorough is the discussion? Like you mentioned breast ironing as well. That falls under the same
right.
Body modifications.
Well, what I speak to specifically is genital mutilation of young girls in other countries and the impact it has upon them and their development. That's specifically what I talk about, and then I specifically talk about breast ironing as a way for people to think about how women are oftentimes oppressed under those conditions, and how that can again be not only harmful to the body, but also harmful to the culture.
Oh, I see.
Snip it! Chicks and convertibles! Back!
Average adult foreskin is the size of that Bloodstained Men info card.
That's what I heard.
It's a double layer skin, so it folds in half and wraps around, and that's what covers the head of the penis in the intact male.
Uh-huh.
The outer foreskin is like an extension of the shaft skin. The inner foreskin is mucous membrane, like the inside of your lip or the inside of your eyelid.
Yeah.
And then in between these two layers, you have the dartosfaciae muscle tissue. That's the same muscle that's in the scrotum that responds to external temperature to bring the testicles closer to the body if it gets cold, for instance. It works the same way with the foreskin and the head of the penis. And then there's also lots of blood vessels in here, lots of nerve pathways that terminate in these Meissner's corpuscles, which are very fine-touch nerve endings like you have in your fingertips and your lips. And in the clitoral hood in the female, that's the analogous structure to the male foreskin. And they exist right here in the ridged band at this prepucial sphincter, where the tip of the foreskin is. And so this entire structure is totally destroyed when it's amputated. And then the head of the penis becomes an external organ, which it's not supposed to be. It should be warm and moist and protected all the time.
Okay.
Instead, now it's rubbing up against the underwear, it gets covered with a layer of keratin, which is like a callus, it dries out.
Yeah.
And so not only do you lose the sensation in the part of the penis that was destroyed, but what remains is further desensitized.
Okay.
And this also messes with the mechanics of intercourse, because if the foreskin's not there, every time the man comes out of his partner, the lubrication will get caught behind the coronal ridge and drawn out into the air where it will dry out. But if the foreskin's there, it will retract on the way in and it will cover the head of the penis on the way out so that the moisture stays inside. So there's a huge market for artificial lubrication in American pharmacies.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have this problem in Europe and Asia and South America where the men's penises are working the way they were designed.
Okay, thanks for the information, man.
Yeah, the more you learn about the functions of the foreskin, the more disturbing it is that this body part is being stolen from us.
Yeah.
So spread the word, warn your friends if they're having babies.
Will do.
Cool.
Thanks.
Equal rights for baby boys! Body belongs to you, natural!
Have you heard the good news? You don't have to cut your son's penis.
That's totally fine. You have a right to care about what you want to care about.
Yeah,
but what's important is that you don't force these on a child.
Yeah, but
children deserve protection. And if you ever have kids, or if you know anyone having kids,
does the baby lose anything? If a baby 0 years old, 0 seconds on earth,
they
can't possibly
consent.
I mean, it's done for religious reasons. It's done for all
purposes. Sorry to interrupt.
I mean, they do it in Jewish cultures. It's a Christian thing. It's been going on for centuries. I mean,
that's true.
If you abide by it from all standpoints of culture, then if you want your child to abide by it, then I can't say anything about it.
Personally, I'm angry because part of my penis has been cut off.
Yeah? How old are you?
I'm 36.
So 36 years ago, have you been mourning the loss of your foreskin for 36 years?
Yes.
Have you nothing better to do than to be upset that a little piece of skin got cut off your dick 36 years ago?
Yes. Well, it's more than just skin, actually.
What is it?
It's got muscles in it.
Can you still perform sexually?
I can partially perform, but...
This guy fucks. This guy fucks with a circumcised penis, so I think we can... We can come full circle
like
and agree
penis.
That it's all good.
I like my penis, you know? Do you like your penis?
Yeah, but you just said that you're circumcised and you like your penis, so doesn't that kind of defeat your message?
Well, I like what I have left of it, and I wish I had the whole thing.
Oh, you're going to backtrack a little bit. Okay.
I think, you know, I would have liked the part that was cut off, too.
Really?
Yeah.
What if you hadn't liked it? Would you have performed a circumcision yourself?
Well, at least then I would...
If you had the opportunity, would you regraft your penis with the skin that was lost?
There, people have done that.
Would you do it?
And
for the cause, would you do it?
Well, the problem is
for the cause, man. Bloodstainedmen.com. Would you do it? Would you reattach the skin to your penis?
You can't. The problem really is that. That's not possible.
Tosh asked me that question. You know who Tosh is?
Who?
Daniel Tosh.
Tosh.0?
Yeah, he asked me that question 3 weeks ago on Comedy Central.
Really?
Yeah.
What did you answer?
You're going to have to look at the episode to see. It's on YouTube.
I'm going to assume no, but... Huh.
Go to on YouTube, go to Tosh.0 Brother K. K is in kind.
Boys, come here. Come here.
How much of y'all's dick y'all got left?
Y'all circumcised or not?
Man.
Yes.
I am.
I wish I had my foreskin back.
He's 36 years old, been mourning the loss of his foreskin.
It should be a man's choice, not a parent's choice. That's the bottom line. It's about men's rights. Yeah, it's about the right of a man to decide how much penis he wants to live with, not his parents.
Damn.
Doctors and parents don't have the right to cut off part of a man's penis. It's a fundamental human right.
But it happened,
it doesn't have to happen to your son. Are you going to make it happen to your son just because it happened to you? That's what we're doing.
I have a
daughter. We're alone in the world. What's wrong with American men? Nothing. Our doctors are corrupt, unethical, and greedy.